Welcome to the Redefinition Daily with Ozana, a daily inspiration for a better new life.
Good morning and welcome to the Redefinition with your friend and brother Ozana. We are grateful to God for his faithfulness and his love. We express thanks because this God is a mighty God. He will never put us to shame. That's why we will continue to worship him. We continue to adore him. Blessed be his holy name. We magnify this morning, Lord. Be thou glorified, be thou exalted in the mighty name of Jesus. We thank you, Heavenly Father, because you are faithful to your word. We pray, again, lead us this morning and exalt your mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Let's take this wonderful brand new release from Dunsun Generation. We all praise his name. And his name is Yah. We shall be right back. Just worship the Lord this morning.
Generations after generations, keep praising you. Yet no word sums you up. Then I ask the Lord, what name fits you? And he said, yeah.
Welcome back. We are still on our series, Hate, and this morning we shall be looking at the causes of hate. Our text remains Genesis chapter 37, verses 3 and 4, verses 3 and 4. Now Israel loved Joseph more than all his children, because he was a son of his old age. Also he made him a tunic of many colors. But when his brothers saw that their father loved him more than all his brothers, they hated him and could not speak peaceably to him. I said earlier we're still on our series Hate, and today we shall look at the causes of hate. We said one of the strongest undoing of the human race is the issue of hatred for one another. We agree that hatred is a sign of weakness. Anybody that hates another person is a sign of weakness, and the end result is not always palatable to both parties. The end result is not always palatable to both parties. We also said if we think that as we live our life, our day-to-day life, that no one hates us, then we are living in deceit. We define hate as intense hostility and aversion, usually deriving from fear, anger, and sense of injury. Anger, fear, and sense of injury. We said hatred is based on the perception of the other, and it affects our personality. It affects our feelings. It affects the ideas we have. It affects our belief and our identity. What then are the causes of hate? By the grace of God, we have been able to align four causes of hate, and we shall be taking them one after the other. Number one, one major cause of hate is inferiority complex. Inferiority complex. People tend to hate others when there's a feeling of inferiority. The brothers of Joseph hated him even the more because they felt inferior to him because he was loved by their father. Genesis chapter 37 verse 4 says, but when his brothers saw that their father loved him the more than all of them, they hated him and could not speak peaceably to him. They felt inferior to him. How would our father make for him a tunic of many colors? And all of us are here. He has not said anything to us before. The brother of the prodigal son felt inferior to him when he came back. Why will our father kill the fattened calf for a man that wasted all his money and have been here suffering with him? Inferiority complex causes hate in our heart. James chapter 4 and verse 1 says, what is causing the quarrels and fights among us? Don't they come from the evil desires at war within us? Inferiority complex causes war within us. And once that war grows up, we begin to hate one another. And it's always difficult to overcome it. Number two, inability to manage our differences. No man is an island of his own. And so far as we are mixing up with other persons in our day-to-day activities, we are bound to, from time to time, offend each other. Again, because we are different from each other, our sense of reasoning cannot be the same. But many, whenever they come into this conflict, cannot accommodate the differences with other people. As a result, hatred sets in. Brethren, we need to manage ourselves. No other person can be like us. We are two different beings from two different backgrounds with two different ideologies. And so when these differences pop up, we should be able to manage it. But many cannot manage these differences. And as a result, hatred sets in. Number three, sometimes hatred is inherited from families. Many people today inherit hatred for others from their friends, their families, or colleagues. Most children grow up with an understanding that certain persons or families are not their family friend, and without actually knowing the real story, carry on with that hatred. Some people sometimes just hate to please their friend or colleague because a member of their circle of friends hates you. They're going to hate you without a cause. Many people hate as inherited from their families. When I was growing up, there was a certain family that we were told that were enemies of our family, and we don't even need to cross their front. So we have to take a very long route going to church. Even going to church, we take a long route while we have a shorter cord that will have passed through their front. And if peradventure we mistakenly pass their front, we are advised never ever to turn our eyes towards their compound at all. We should walk straight because they hate us. Up till now, the reason for the hatred, I don't know. But we grew up into that. It's only Christianity that helps us understand that we don't need to hate anybody. So many persons in life inherit hatred from their families. Just inherit to hate people because your family said you should hate them. People inherit hatred from their colleagues. They just hate you because they are friends. They hate to please their friend. Just because they want to make their friend to be happy, they join in the hatred. Number four, envy. Some people you hate out of envy. Some people are hated out of envy. They just imagine that every good thing should have come to them and not the next person. James chapter 3 verse 14 says, if you harbor bitter envy, if you harbor bitter envy and selfish ambition in your heart, do not boast about it or deny the truth. So we are not supposed to harbor envy. People hate people because of a lot of, they are envious. They just feel every good thing should be them. It can't be the next person. Why is she the one being favored? Why is she the one that is always not laboring? Why is she the one that is always being loved? Why is he the one that will not stress himself? Why is he the one that anytime, even if he commits a mistake, makes a mistake, nobody takes into recognition? Why not me? Envy. People envy your status. They envy your position. They envy your achievement. They envy your family. Everything. Even some people envy your stress. They don't even understand the volume of stress you are passing through. But they just want to be the one being busy. And unfortunately, when they get to that point, they don't understand that it's not the way they are seeing it. People envy your success. Others go to the point of envying your failure. But the Bible lets us to understand that we should not harbor bitter envy and selfish ambitions in our hearts. God is love, like we said, and all of us are advised to love. The brothers of Joseph hated him because their father loved him and gave him a coat of many colors. As children of God, we are supposed to shine as light to lighten every darkness of this world, and we should not hate. The Bible says, love your enemies. I encourage us this morning that we should build love to overcome hatred. Let love overcome selfishness. Let love overcome the envy we have against other persons. Let's understand that there's a time and a season for everything under heavens. And if God is our God, he will be faithful to us in all things. God cannot abandon his children. God cannot allow us to fail. He is a faithful God. Let's put our trust in him. Let's not feel inferior to any person. God have made us say we are fearfully and wonderfully made. We are fearfully and wonderfully made. We are not inferior to any person. Let's not walk the path of hatred with the mindset that we are inferior to any other person. Let's always cry unto God, because God is faithful to his words. Let us pray this morning. Father, we worship you. We give you praise. We keep praising you. We keep exalting your name. We continue to magnify you because there is none like you. We ask this morning, Heavenly Father, take away from us every harbor of envy and bitterness. Take away from us every sin that easily besets us. Take away from us everything that makes us to deny the truth. Lord, we ask that this year, as it's starting afresh, Heavenly King, that we shall have a clean slate of heart and conscience, so that the blessings you have in store for us will not be taken away from us. Thank you, Heavenly Father. I pray for that one this morning that men have hated out of nothing. I pray for that family this morning that have been condemned, destroyed by the words of mouth, by the imaginations of the evil imaginations of the heart of men, out of nothing. I pray in the place of hatred, let your love reign. Let your love reign. I pray for that soul this morning.